Hi, this is Jennifer from Soul Source Tarot, and I am here to do your weekly reading for the 20th through the 26th of August. This is for the sign of Scorpio. Moved right to the top of the list, okay? So, Scorpio. Generally, my readings are love readings. We're going to see what happens, you know, whatever happens, happens. This is for Scorpio, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. Ooh, fell out. Stay optimistic about your love life. Positive thinking and faith will bring you romance. Interesting. We're going to get one more. Stay positive. Stay optimistic. Whatever's going on, you know, it probably could work out, but you have to be positive. Oh, worth waiting for. Divine timing is at work in your love life. Beautiful. Love it. Maybe the time is now. And, you know, it could be now because on my way, you know, I was planning on doing my readings, my this week's segment, and I was in the car on my way home, and I was trying to think of my thumbnail that I was going to put for this segment, and I kept on thinking, now, I got to have something that resonates with now. But I chose something different, but that's what I was thinking on the way here was now. And you know, I did choose four aces for the thumbnail. So aces are new beginnings right now. So something is happening right now. Maybe it's something you've been waiting for, Scorpio. Oh, we had a flyer. Four of Swords reverse, coming out of a rest, coming out of a break, coming out of a situation where you may have felt lonely or empty. You may have felt almost like overwhelmed, okay, in your own thoughts. Alone, I see like loneliness. But it looks like you are being tempted this week, you know, to step forward, to move forward, to stop staying wherever you've been, you know, to step out, to take the steps, you know, to keep going. Okay. Don't give up. Don't give up on love. This is a love reading. This is temptation. Okay. You have a Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. You have Capricorn here. So I'm not sure if you are tempted. There's an opportunity to head down a new path. You know, if you can find that, keep the strength and find the strength to do so, to leave this situation. You may have been staying in a dead end situation that was only hurting you, but you are definitely dealing with a Taurus, Virgo, or Capricorn, okay? Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, Taurus, Capricorn. So I'm not sure, you know, it's an earth sign. I think that you're dealing with an earth sign. I feel as though, you know, this is the Queen of Pentacles. She is very stable, secure, solid, devoted, nurturing, caring, businesslike. She has a lot of perseverance within her. I feel as though either you guys are taking on that energy or this person is walking into your life or you are walking into theirs. Walking, not running, walking. Okay? And this is a very practical person. Okay? There's a lack of faith and trust, though, and that's why this came up. Stay optimistic about your love life. You may be worried that this is just lust. You may be worried that this person doesn't really want a commitment. You may be worried that, you know, if I let my guard down and let this person in, are they just after me for one thing? You know, I think that you're wanting probably a commitment, and you're worried that, you know, you've been hurt in the past. Your guard is up. You're worried that, you know, this might not lead to a commitment. You may feel like you're dealing, somebody might have tricks up their sleeve. You've probably been duped, you know, and this is kind of in the past, present, future. Okay. So this is like, I think that you've been duped. You've been taken advantage of, manipulated and lied to in the past. And that's why your guard is up now. Yeah. It's like you're reluctant. You're reluctant to let your guard down with this person. You know, here we have another person, okay, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. This is confidence, willpower, focus. This is also about taking the lead. So, Scorpio, you think you have a choice between two options, okay? You probably have a choice between, you know, two people, an earth sign and a fire sign. That's what it looks like to me. I feel as though there's some hurt, there's some disappointment, emotional disappointment. You're reluctant to move forward with this person, perhaps because there was another person that hurt you really, really badly. I mean, that's what it looks like. I see the hurt. I do. You're reluctant. This is, I mean, and fives are conflict. I'm reluctant to get myself involved in any conflict. 5, 5, 5, you know, but whatever's happening, there's a major life change here that is happening for your highest good, even though you may not see it that way. And I do feel that you are very tempted to go down this new path, whatever it is. But let me get this focused in and we're going to, wow, this focused pretty well, isn't it? Get a little bit closer here. Can't really see that one. But maybe if we put it up there. There we go. We'll put them both up there. There we go. Okay, so there's a lack of faith. There's a lack of faith in love, perhaps. I mean, that's what it looks like to me. So let's get some clarifiers here. This magician reversed. You've been lied to and duped and tricked. Okay, that's how other people see you in that position. You know, other people probably see that your guard is up. Okay, you know that you're afraid. They probably see that. Yeah, you have been of hurt bad. Stabbed right in the heart by somebody. So that's why your guard is up. It's like, oh man, I really don't want to get my heart broken again. But you have an offer coming in. You do. You have a solid, stable offer coming in which, you know, I want to clarify right here. Whew, you're going to have to be logical, okay? Use logic with making this decision. You have to make a tough decision. You have to be the judge. You have to make a choice. You have to make a decision between two paths, and that's all there is to it. This is the judge, okay? One person has hurt you very badly, okay? I'm not sure which one, but I see that you're reluctant, and you've been waiting for something to happen, waiting for a change. I feel as though you may have stuck it out in one arena for quite some time. You know, you've tried. Tried to hold on to something for quite some time. It could be a Leo. We have Leo here as well. This is Leo as well. But I think that you've tried to, you know, hold on to some sort of happiness. But this, so this is independence. This is enjoying life on your own, making yourself happy. You know, I think that what has happened here is you've been through some major hurt with somebody. Major, major, major hurt. Okay. These are all swords. Okay. So maybe it was a air sign, Libra, Gemini, Aquarius. Okay. I think either, or it could be any of them. Okay. Just saying. I think that there's been some major hurt here that has caused you to have your guard up. You've probably been working on healing and working on your singlehood, you know, enjoying life, getting back to yourself, okay? And I think that you've been working on your own abundance. Some of you have. Some of you, need to get to this spot of the ultimate abundance on your own, your ultimate happiness. You need to allow time to heal if you haven't done that. Healing is needed, okay? So, you know, nines are also, it's time to move on. You know, it's a sign to move on. We have a nine here and a nine here. Nines, right here, okay, right in the middle is happiness. Okay, this is a sign card. The card is happiness and bliss. If you make the right decision to move on from something that you've been holding on to that really hurt you in the past, that left you feeling dead and empty on the inside, if you move on from that, you will find happiness. Okay, right in the center of your reading is the Queen of Pentacles. So it's an earth sign. So whoever this earth sign is very prominent this week. And she's prominent to your stability and your security because that's who she is. But I see that your guard is up. Oh, And you see where I put it? I didn't even think. There is, somebody has to make a decision in regards to love, in regards to a partnership. There's an opportunity for love here. A beautiful union. But, of course, there's a but. You definitely could be dealing with a Taurus. I'm not sure. But, I mean, could be a Libra as well. But I feel as though, you know, somebody doesn't know what they're worth. Somebody doesn't know what they're worth. And it's, I think there's a, you could be dealing with somebody that has a lot of options. Okay? And maybe you know this person has a lot of options. Because the Empress in reverse is a woman that has a lot of options. People chase her and sometimes she doesn't know what to do. Okay, so I feel as though you could be dealing with a person that has a lot of options, and you may think, you know, this is just, you know, this person is just looking for, you know, well, this is the devil, you know, lust. But let's see what this person is really looking for. You know, there's an opportunity for love here. Ah, this is somebody that wants a commitment. This is family. This is a family man. So somebody, you're dealing with somebody who does want a family, somebody that does want to settle down, somebody that is very confident in who they are, whether it's a fire sign or an earth sign or an air sign. Could be, but that's what I see. I see fire, earth, and air. I feel as though you have to have confidence. That's why Stay Optimistic came up. Be confident. Think positive about this, okay? I think that you're really afraid that you know, the devil, there's chains here, okay? Normally in the cards, there's chains where they're chained together. To bond. You're afraid to bond with someone. I think that you're definitely have your guard up. You've been wounded in the past and your guard is up. You're afraid to bond with someone new. That's why Stay Optimistic came up, because you have to have confidence. Be confident. You know, there's an opportunity for equal give and take here, to receive what you deserve. Somebody wants to give you something. Somebody has something to offer you, and you have something to offer them. It's on a mutual basis, but you're reluctant to allow. You're reluctant to move on from something that has no growth. Oh my goodness, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn again. You have an opportunity for something that could be really beneficial to you. You do. There's stability, security, perseverance, equality. And you definitely have a choice between two options. I think it's an earth sign and a fire sign. We have it, okay? It's amazing because we have the Queen of Pentacles and the Queen of Wands under here. Then we have the King of Pentacles and the King of Wands right here. You have a choice between a fire sign and an earth sign. That's what it looks like to me. And there is a soulmate connection, because when you have them like this, there's a soulmate connection. There's absolutely no doubt about it. There's a soulmate connection. But somebody is reluctant to allow it. Damn. There is definitely a soulmate connection. But the thing is you may think the wrong one is your soulmate. And that's what the Lover's card would suggest in reversed. You have to end one contract with somebody that isn't the soulmate that you may think is the soulmate, so the soulmate can come into your life. You're reluctant to move on from this person who you think is your soulmate, but is not your soulmate, that hurt you. Oh my goodness gracious. So there is some sort of contract that needs to end so that you can find peace and harmony and balance and equality and stability and security with another person. There's an opportunity for a soulmate connection here. But you're going to have to take steps in that direction or lose out. So, Scorpio, I mean, you have to make a decision here. You do. Do you want love or not? This is indecision about love. This is what this is. It's an indecision about love. Maybe you don't know what you're worth because this person hurt you so badly, whoever it was. There's an opportunity for a love connection here. Please don't pass it up. Oh, karma. That's judgment. Okay? There's an opportunity for you to release the past, forgive the past, and take a chance with somebody else. This is karma. This is a wake-up call. You have an opportunity for love if you could just see it. This is a soulmate connection that you have been waiting for. You have. Stay optimistic. Positive thinking and faith will bring you romance. Don't look at this in a negative way. Don't think that this person is out to hurt you or only going to hurt you, you know, that they are only looking for one thing. Try to think of it as, you know what? There's room for growth here. There's room for stability. There's an opportunity to have a family with this person. You know, look at it in a positive light instead of a negative light. This is an opportunity of a lifetime. You know, when I was shuffling these cards, I wanted to see this could be the one. That's what was going on in my head. This could be the one. This could be the one. I think that you have a choice between two people, and you have to decide, you know, to allow this person to love you, whoever it is. And it feels as though your guard is really up and you're protecting yourself from love. Because I think you know that you could fall in love with this person. So your guard is up. So anyway, I feel like there's an opportunity this week in which you need to really, the Five of Cups is realizing that you have an opportunity, another opportunity, a new opportunity. You have if you could stop focusing on the loss and the hurt and the betrayal and the sadness from the past, the new opportunity is upright and it is waiting for you. It is. It's waiting for you. So I feel like, Scorpio, this is a week of making a decision. Do you want this soulmate connection? Because that's what this is. But you're going to have to end one contract first. That's what I have. Talk to you later. This is turned. I just noticed it. This is coming out. Coming out of rest, coming out of a dead-end situation. That's what it is. It's over. It's time for me to become alive again. Talk to you later.